Good day everyone, so welcome back to my YouTube channel. For today's video, I am going to discuss my answer in learning activity 5 and AG04 or known as organic chemistry. So the learning activity 5 is containing four questions, but we only choose at least 3 questions. Then what, tanong ko lang, ano yung pagkakaiba ng alkene and alkyne sa isa't isa? So, alkyne is saturated, meaning maraming hydrogen ang nako-contain niya. Then, alkene and alkyne is unsaturated, meaning few lang yung nako-contain nilang hydrogen. Dahil sa double bonded sila. Then, alkyne is hindi sila double bonded kundi single bonded lang, di ba? Straight line lang yung nako-contain ng alkane. So, what are we waiting for? Let's start our video. The topic that we are discussing right now is all about alkene and alkyne. Number one question is, give the name of alkene by showing the process step by step. So, mini ipapakita ko kung paano ko nakuha yung name ng problem na to. So, we always remember that we have a rule to guide us or to use so that we can come up the right name of this problem. So, the first is name the parents hydrocarbon, meaning ininame natin kung ano yung pinaka-longest hydrocarbon. Paano natin malalaman yung pinaka-longest hydrocarbon dito? By identifying the longest carbon chain. So, i-identify natin ang longest carbon chain dito sa problem. But we always remember that the longest carbon chain must include the double bonded. Kailangan naka-include doon ang double bonded, which is this. Kailangan naka-include ito sa longest carbon chain. For example, we need to count the longest carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Or, it's the same. So, the 4 is the longest carbon, which is equals to butane. And because it is present double bonded, it will come as a butene. Yung N, mapapalitan ng in. So, magiging butene na siya. The next step is number the carbon atoms in the chain. Magna-number tayo dito sa problem na to, yung longest carbon chain. So, magiging ganito na siya. Bakit? Dito ako nag-start. Dahil, kailangan mag-start at the near of double bonded ang number. Dapat nagsa-start siya sa double bonded. Another hint is, kapag equal yung double bonded, for example, nalagay dito yung double bonded. So, una sa lahat is, magka-count tayo kung saan yun mas malapit ang subsequent, for example, dito. Pero dahil hindi siya equal ng point out ng double bonded, kailangan natin magsimula dito sa near talaga. Near at double bonded. So, dito nag-start. The next step is write the full name. Merong nilagay si ma'am dun sa course pack namin na process para hindi kami malito masyado. So, there are parent name, which is the butane, the substituent, or the prefix, which is 3-methyl. Bakit siya 3-methyl? Kasi po, naka-point out siya dito sa number 3 carbon, yung CH3. Kulangan ng 3. Sorry. CH3. Yung CH3, naka-point siya dito sa carbon 3. Kaya naging 3-methyl siya. Bakit methyl? Kasi CH3, only one carbon is equals to methyl. So, double bonded attach. San nakalagay or san naka-attach na number ang double bonded? Kung natanong or nakita ninyo yung answer ko is, C1 or carbon 1 dahil dito nag-start ang carbon 1. I mean, kung yung pinaka lowest number, yun yung isusulat natin. So, this is it. Then last, the suffix, meaning yung last number niya. Suffix is alkene, meaning for the presence of double bond is alkene. Presence ng double bond, kaya siya naging in kasi presence of double bond siya. Kaya yung final name natin is this. 3-methyl-both-1-ene. Bakit siya naging ganito? Ang kung saan ang 3-methyl ay nanggaling sa subsistent, ang both is the parent name or the longest carbon chain, ang 1 kung saan naka-attach yung double bonded, ang ene which is the suffix, yung priority order principal niya. So for the question number 2, give the name of this alkene by showing the process step by step. This is the problem number 2. So, alkane, meaning tatlong double bonded ang naka-represent dito sa problem na to. Hindi na alkene, na double bonded, kundi tatlo. Ganun pa rin yung process natin. Gagamitin pa rin natin yung rule para hindi tayo malito. At una sa lahat ay hahanapin natin yung name of the parent's hydrocarbon by identifying the longest carbon chain. So, magka-count tayo kung saan yung banda yung pinaka-longest carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, that is the longest carbon chain number 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, it's the same. Pero, ang sinasabi sa number 1 or sa step 1 ay dapat naka-include yung triple bonded or yung priority principal, priority order per principal sa counting ng longest carbon chain. And maaapektuhan ang number 2, ang step 2, kapag hindi kasali ang triple bonded. Kaya dito tayo mag-start or dito yung longest carbon chain. So, the longest carbon will be 6 is equal to hexane. By the presence of triple bonded, it will be hexane, meaning H-E-X-Y-N-E, yung magiging spelling niya, hexane. The next step is step 2, number the carbon in atom chain. Dito, dapat magsa-start pa rin sa near at the triple bonded. So, saan ba tayo magsa-start? At the left side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. The next step is write the full name. Yun pa rin yung ginamit ko sa number 1 is the parent name, which is the hexane kasi 6 carbon chain siya. And subsistent prefix or the 3-methyl. Bakit siya 3-methyl? Dahil yung subsistent is naka-point out siya sa number 3 carbon na counting. Kaya naging 3-methyl siya. 3-methyl. Triple bonded attach is in the carbon 1 kasi yun yung pinaka-first number na naka-attach. And next is suffix is in, meaning for the alkene presence by triple bonded. So, the final name will be 3-methyl hex dash 1-ene dahil nga ang 3 is the number of subsistent, methyl is the subsistent, hex is the longest carbon chain, 1 is the attachment number, ene is the suffix. For the question number 3, give the name of this cycloalkenes showing the process step by step. So, nandito na tayo sa cycloalkenes. This is the problem. Ipapakita ko sa inyo. This is the problem. So, ipaprocess natin siya step by step. First, we are going to identify the name of the parent's carbon by by finding the carbon chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 is equal to the name parents is pentane. The next is number the atom in chain, which is the number start near the double bonded of cycloalkenes. Ganun pa rin yung process, dapat magsa-start tayo at the near kahit hindi na siya straight. Kaya dito tayo magsa-start, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Step 3, write the full name. So, ganun pa rin yung process na ginawa ko. Name, parent name will be pentane. Subsequent prefix will be trimethyl dahil sa number 3 na carbon siya nakalagay. And then, double bonded attached. Dito tayo is hindi na tayo dapat naglalagay ng number ng triple bonded or double bonded attachment because it is not necessary to specify the position of the double bonded because it always between C1 and C2. Kaya hindi na natin siya inilalagay kasi nandun na siya naka-point out sa C1 and C2. And the suffix is in by presence of cycloalkenes, presence by the double bond. So, the final name will be trimethyl cyclopentane. Dahil diretso na siya, wala na siyang number kasi nga it is not necessary to specify the position of double bonded because it always in C1 and C2. So this is the final answer. So as you can see, wala na siyang number. So the 3 is the number of substituent. The methyl, which is the substituent. The cyclo means ito yung presence name niya dito. And pentane, which is the longest carbon chain. And in for the 3 for the double bonded. Wala na siyang number kasi nga dahil hindi na kailangan specifies ang position ng double bond.